All right, I wanted to introduce myself, Sylvester. Yeah, and on the right is my father, my dad, William Wong, and most right is Christopher Wong, my uncle, and my left is my aunt, Lucy Wong, and the most left is my cousin June Chong. Okay, we are here today to celebrate our great aunt's 75th anniversary of being a Carmelite sister. Yeah, it has been a really long time, and it's really, really great is her faithfulness to our Lord Jesus. I would say she's really a very active lady. Although she's 96 years old, but she looks really healthy and she's very talkative. She has a lot of story to share with us. And she has a very good memory. It's just that she has some hearing problems. She likes to catch a coconut crab and cook for the other sisters and priests or whoever visited her. Yeah. First of all, I want to thank God for God for being so faithful and for His protection and His blessings to my great aunt and all the sisters here. And I would like to thank all the sisters for taking care of my great aunt and for being with her all this while. And I would like to thank everyone for being here to celebrate this special occasion. And I would like to thank as well for everyone for the prayers and support. Truly is a blessing from God to all of us here.
The greatest gift, the gift of life, the gift of love divine. God gave us all a special gift. He meant for it to shine. He meant for it to shine. The darkest night can be made light by one bright word or smile. If we
Well, we wanted to leave the Carmelite cloister and come to the heart of the church, the cathedral, join the Archbishop and all his brother priests we pray for, so that the sisters could, in a jubilant way, renew their vows. And I thought was significant, we were renewing the vows right next to the baptismal font for the vows that the nuns take, poverty, chastity, and obedience, are a deepening of the baptismal vow that we all have. So we're very grateful to see so many friends, new and old, and happy day, happy Jubilee.
God gave us all our own free will to choose the paths we take. No greater deed could ever be done than for another's sake.
Body, may never feel forsaken by God, we pray to the Lord.
Glory
to God. May God deliver her and cause her to happiness and accompany her with all that she always desired. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
In baptism, she died with Christ. May she also share.
share in his resurrection.
Sister Teresa, because there are many times they'll be sitting eating and they'll ask me come and join, and I said no, I ate already. And she loved when I find them eating, she loved the pizza. But now that it's gone, Sister Teresa Margaret, everybody will miss, even the people that come to church, they will miss her because they know her for a long time too. So may God look, make her look down for us and pray for us, because that's what they do.
Sister Teresa Margaret, we want to thank you for being an inspiration to all of us and for giving us an opportunity to get closer to Christ and for inspiring us in how to live our Christianity. We thank you so much. It's a gift that we will carry with us, hopefully to heaven, where we hope to meet with you. Not soon, I hope, but to meet with you and to be in the presence of Christ and all the angels and saints and yourself, which I'm sure will become a saint.
Thank you so much to Archbishop and all our brother priests and all our friends of Carmel and so many people who follow us in the body of Sister Teresa Margaret down to Malola for her Mass to celebrate her resurrection into new life. And Sister Teresa Margaret, continual prayer, I can assure you, as prioress, and all of you were remembered in her prayer and will continue, I'm sure, for all eternity. Teresa Margaret, God bless you. We love you so much, and thank you, and God bless everybody.